Hey, Dan here from Macworld, and today I want to make sure you're protecting your photos. So this is kind of like a PSA. Now, there's a good chance that most of you are already backing up your photos and video from your phone through iCloud, Google Photos, or another service, and that's great. But I'm also sure you probably have a parent or a sibling that isn't, especially if they've already filled up their free allotted iCloud storage. So please go make them or do it for them. Right now, I just want to show you how easy it is to get free protection from losing all your photos if your phone gets lost, stolen, or broken using Google Photos. First, go to the App Store and download Google Photos. Once that's finished, go ahead and open it up. Then you'll need to allow Google Photos to access all your photos. It's your choice on whether you want notifications, and personally, I lean towards no to the distractions. Now you'll have the options to backup and sync, which is exactly what we're trying to do here today, and what quality to save. For unlimited photos and video storage for free, Google Photos will need to compress those images. And to be honest, their compression quality is quite good, so you really won't be missing much. You could save the original quality, but then you'd hit the free storage limit and you'd end up in the same boat as you were with iCloud, so we won't get into that today. Finally, you can choose to use cellular data to backup if there's no Wi-Fi. This is really going to depend on your data plan and the amount of photos and videos you take. If your plan has a limited data cap, or if you're just using Google Photos as a free backup and you're unlikely to touch it very often, then go ahead and leave this off. Log in with your Google account, and if you don't have one, you will need to create one, and then that's it. There are some things to note. First, Google Photos will save all the photos you take on your iPhone, but if you delete something from the Apple Photos app, it won't necessarily also delete it from Google Photos. However, if you try to delete an image from the Google Photos app, it will ask you if you want to remove it from the phone locally as well. Second, the background upload isn't perfect, and you may occasionally want to open up the app to force a backup. But with these settings though, I had a good backup experience if the phone was both on Wi-Fi and plugged in charging. Finally, if you edit a photo in the Apple Photos app, Google will treat that edit as a new image and save it in addition to the unedited one. But with all that said, you should be able to rest a little bit easier knowing that the only priceless things on your iPhone are now a little bit safer.